Pennsylvania state Democrats are outraged after learning a GOP colleague had been diagnosed with coronavirus days before they learned about it. Representative Brian Sims took to social media shortly after he was informed.
You don't get my life. My life belongs to me. It does not belong to you. You had no business, no business putting me and my friends and my colleagues at risk in the way that you have.
Republican lawmaker Andrew Lewis said in a statement that his last day at the Capitol was May 14th. Lewis learning that he tested positive for coronavirus 6 days later, and then he immediately went into self-quarantine. As to why Democratic lawmakers learned about it a week later, the press secretary to the Pennsylvania House Majority Leader sent out this response. A person's personal medical history or condition is protected by HIPAA law, so we would be breaking the law if we announced anything about his medical status or even information that could lead to him being identified. The 48 hours before symptoms onset is worth nothing. By that timeline, Representative Lewis was only in the Capitol for a short period of time within that window, so tracing who he was in contact with was easily verified. Representative Brian Sims joining me now. Tell us exactly, as you learned that your Republican colleague had tested positive, and then just break down the concern here, because what we know, right, is that he found out on the 20th, backtracking, May 20th, test on the 18th, and he had been in on the House floor on the 14th, where Democrats and Republicans were obviously present.
You've got that timeline perfectly right, Brandon. Thank you for having me. And that's really where all of our heads went as we began to learn about this sort of ongoing cover-up, which it is still ongoing. I am still here in this building. We still know next to nothing about how many people have tested positive, how many people have been tested, how many people are under quarantine. I understand that there was a question raised about HIPAA violations, and I want to be clear. We've not asked for the name of any person who's tested positive, but we do need to know what committees they serve on, what days they were in the building. And to your point about this member that tested positive, what we've subsequently learned, and we've only, again, learned this by prying this out of the Republican leadership who control this building, we've subsequently learned that this member got the results of his test on the 20th, and he tested on the 18th. Now, per the CDC guidelines, the incubation period for COVID-19 is between 2 and 14 days, which meant that this member was potentially infected and infectious from the 4th on. Now, we as a legislature were in session on the 4th, 5th, and 6th, and again on the 11th, 12th, and 13th, where this member interacted with members across the floor, members in committee, certainly in the committees that I serve on. And more importantly, I think that if you ever to see a video of what the Republicans on the Pennsylvania House floor look like at any given time, there is no social distancing. The vast majority of them aren't wearing masks, aren't taking this seriously. And so this idea that by simply quarantining maybe the last two or three of his own colleagues that he interacted with after finding out he was positive is the same as a contact trace that's required by public health and the CDC is laughable if it wasn't so deadly.
And one of the frustrations is the fact that Republicans wanted, and sort of against the advice of health experts, they wanted to convene in person.
Yeah, that's exactly right. You know, the Pennsylvania legislature has probably met more than any other legislature in the country during the COVID-19 crisis. And it's because we're a gerrymandered legislature. There are nearly a million more Democrats in this state than Republicans, but using sophisticated algorithms and gerrymandering, Republicans are still currently in control of the House. And so they've used these months to grandstand. They've used these months to try to hurt a governor, to try to hurt a secretary of health who are doing impeccable work, who are saving thousands of lives. And every day they've come in and they've told us that it was safe to interact, that these restrictions were overbearing, that different industries could interact as long as people could just follow those CDC guidelines. And now what we're learning is that was a lie and that they weren't even following those guidelines themselves.
So they're saying it's about HIPAA law. And to your point about not identifying the person, leadership also saying they couldn't release even information that could lead to him being identified. You do not believe this statement that they put out. Why do you think then, what is your opinion of why Republicans kept this quiet?
Sure. I think it's twofold. One, we're in the middle of negotiating a budget right now for the entire Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. And we've gotten some indication that as Republicans have used these last months to grandstand, that they were going to use this time period to also dramatically impact our state budget. And so I think for them to be testing positive at the same time that they're trying to tell everyone else that our governor and our secretary of health are wrong for requiring the lockdown, for requiring masks and social distancing, I think it was both counter to their narrative, but also counter to their power grab.
It's worth noting, just for you personally, you know, I think a lot of people saw the video of you very upset. And once you dug into it a little bit, we realized that you're actually someone who's immunocompromised. You donated a kidney, right? This puts you at risk. There are a lot of people, I imagine, who are at risk in the Pennsylvania legislature. Tell us about how that in particular factors into your thinking about this.
Sure. You know, every one of us takes the people that we interact with in our lives as we find them, but we don't know what their lives are like. After we learned about the potential exposure to all of us, most of the Democratic caucus had to get on a call with the Secretary of Health. And the stories and the questions that were shared were heartbreaking. Colleagues of mine disclosing that they have spouses that are immunocompromised, people talking about the risk to their children. For me, yeah, I did. I donated a kidney back in January to a gentleman who was in renal failure. He's doing fantastic, and I'm doing fantastic. But it doesn't change the fact that I am immunocompromised, and it wasn't for the Republican leaderships, it wasn't for them to lie and to continue to cover up this public health crisis here in the building and to put all of us at risk. And, you know, I look at the chairman of the committee that we've been serving on with a number of these members, and he has two small children. I have a colleague that has a newborn baby, a preemie. I have a close colleague that's got a 14-month-old baby. And we go home to these families at night. These are the families that we've decided that we can be safe around. And little did we know that because of a lie and because of a cover-up and because of partisanship and because of the dirtiest of politics, that my Republican colleagues were putting all of our families, all of our staffs, and all of our constituents at grave risk.
Brian Sims, thank you so much from the Pennsylvania State House. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Brianna.